Yo, what's good YouTube? This is Jay from TNJ, and welcome to the offseason after season 3. We just missed the playoffs, and here's what happened. The Twins ran through the AL and on to the World Series. Just take a look. They won the wild card game. They won 3-1 versus the Indians, won 4-1 versus the Angels, and 4-0 swept the New York Mets in the World Series. I mean, what a magical run. Remember, this was a team that we actually beat a couple times down the stretch. Jorge Polanco hit .533 in the World Series, and he takes home the MVP after a second straight .300 season. He could be on his way to getting a nice hefty extension, but he is getting up there in age. Not saying he's getting old, but he will probably demand a contract extension if he keeps progressing the way he is. Now, let's talk about the offseason and head into this season where I don't know what I'm going to be looking at in free agency. So I need to be smart here, and I need to tender Carlos Santana. We cannot break this offense up, and I think that it's smart to just offer him that qualifying offer, because if I do lose him, I will get that first round pick, which will be very, very valuable, because our farm system, to be honest, right now is pretty weak. So we need to kind of shore up our future and make sure we're a good organization going forward. Now, we do extend Corey Lee to a 4-year, $34 million contract. I wanted to offer him that because I want to solidify that he will be the future of this team. I'm going to stick with him. He's probably going to be a lifer for us. I love what he can do. I love his potential. He's got speed at catcher. It's very, very rare. So looking at the free agents, man, this class is loaded. Just looking at every position, this top pitchers, Aaron Nola, Luis Severino, Jose Berríos, Jameson Taillon, Sean Manea. I mean, the list goes on and on. Now, this offseason, we don't really need relief pitching, which is a first, because every single season we've had to have gone after relief, but I don't need to do anything there. But Gary Sanchez is there, Josh Bell, Carlos Santana obviously is there, Jesus Aguilar, I'm not sure we'll go after him, but some other guys like CJ Cron and other big-time first baseman, Jose Abreu is also there, but he's age 36 now. Ronald Odor is there, Starlin Castro, Jose Ramirez. I mean, look at this, shortstop, Trey Turner, Dansby Swanson, Gene Segura is down there, Elvis Andrews is there. I mean, I have not seen a deeper class than this. Look at this, the MVP, JD Martinez is there, Joey Gallo, Benintendi, Byron Buxton, Lou Kane, Lorenzo Kane, Aaron Judge. I have never seen a free agent class this deep. I mean, we have to consider spending big money here in order to get one of these top guys. The first guy I look at is Gary Sanchez. I did just lock up Corey Lee, but remember when I pointed out that Corey Lee can play both outfield positions and shortstop. There is a possibility that I can move him to the outfield, much like Bryce Harper did in his career. Remember, he wasn't always an outfielder. He was a catcher in college and high school, and then when he got to the pros, he started playing outfield. Now I look at Benintendi, and I look at what he can bring to the table. I don't know what's up with him. Why is he not hitting .300? He has the player quirks for hitting machine. He has one of the highest clutch ratings, one of the highest contacts. For some reason, he doesn't hit .300, though. So then I look at the power in our lineup, and I see that we're losing Jesus Aguilar and possibly Carlos Santana. I look at Joey Gallo. He has a good arm, but he's going to strike out a whole lot. And look what he's demanding, a 7-year, $180 million deal from the Texas Rangers. So then I look at starting pitching. Jose Berríos is a perfect candidate to give a contract to. 28 years old. He's an all-around great pitcher. He's not had a bad year since being a pro, really. And I'm going to offer him a 5-year, $127 million deal. We're going to break the bank on him. Now, he will be our highest paid guy on the team if he commits, but I do need to address just some holes here. And I look at DH as a whole, and I look at Corey Dickerson. He's not going to be much of a guy in the field, but I like him right now. A lot of you guys have said to try to go after him. He's now a free agent, so I can officially go after him now without giving anything up except money. And I like this contract at age 33, 2 years, about $10.5 million. I think that's a fair deal for him, and I think he provides good production, and I think that he will be a good option at DH. Now, Scooter Gennett, now, his contract was up. I just don't see letting him go. I mean, he's been great for us. I mean, look at the improvement. 225 year one, 262 year two, 281 year three. I mean, he's just doing good, and I want to keep him around. He might be a lifer in this series for the Kings. I really love doing that. So now we advance on and take a look at the signings. Aaron Nola signs with the Brewers, 6 year, $125 million deal. Definitely comparable to the deal we offered Jose Barrios, but it was 5 years. Joey Gallo moves on to the New York Yankees. So they lose Gary Sanchez and possibly Aaron Judge, and they go after Joey Gallo, adding another power bat to their lineup. So an AL team gets better, but now we start to think about some things. So some big money is going to be thrown around, and Jose Barrios, that's a lot of money going into one guy. So I look at other starters, and I want to see who can give us similar production and maybe less money. Robbie Ray is an option, but looking at his whip, he's not very good there. I don't really know if this is a good idea. Jimmy Pelko, remember, we have him in our organization. He is a lefty, and he's pretty good. I mean, he's about at 78 overall. I think next year he'll probably hit about 80-something. So I don't really need another lefty along with Alex Wood. But then I look at Joe Musgrove. Now, he's 30 years old, but look at the numbers. They're there. The wins aren't there, but it's because their offense isn't that good. But the career whip is 119, really good. Last year he had a 112 whip, and he had 168 strikeouts to 57 walks. He's not going to walk many guys. 109 whip the year before. It makes a lot of sense to go after him and give him maybe a cheaper deal. Look at how much money we will save, over $10 million. And I think that we should go after him, so we will offer him that contract, and he accepts. So Barrios took a couple of days, and he did not accept. So we go after Joe Musgrove instead and get him on a cheaper deal, maybe even equal production. And like I said, he doesn't have the wins added to his resume. But I think this is a great move. I know a lot of you guys had said to trade for him as well, but now he comes to our team on a cheaper deal than what Barrios would have had. Now look at this. Here's in comparison. Luis Severino gets a $19.65 million deal for a 6 year contract. So just looking at the difference, I mean, that is a huge difference in saving money. But the Twins lose Barrios possibly, and they gain a relief pitcher and two. Jose Leclerc also goes with them on a 5 year, $30 million deal. So a pretty good deal for him at the tail end of his 20s. Then the Yankees lose Gary Sanchez. He signs with the Cubs, 5 years, about $100 million deal. And then the Pirates don't really replace Musgrove, but they steal away Aaron Judge. They give him a 6 year, $111 million deal. I feel like he would be worth way more than that. I think MLB The Show is just getting the contract numbers right. I think that Judge would sign for way more than that in real life. Another AL team gets stronger, though. Trey Turner signs with the Red Sox, 7 year, $140 million deal. And I don't know what they're going to do in the infield. They're pretty deep there because they have Trey Turner. They have Xander Bogaerts now. I don't know what they're going to do in that middle infield, but it's going to be really interesting. The Pirates get stronger, and they steal away Benintendi too. So they sign a Yankee, they sign a Red Sox, and now another outfielder. That was actually a pretty favorable deal. I'm surprised he took that. Josh Bell signs with the Nationals. What a class this is. The Nationals go ahead and try to replace Brantley. Remember, they had him last season, and he won, I believe, the World Series MVP. But look at the Twins. They sign Sean Manea, and then Byron Buxton goes to the Yankees. I mean, these AL teams are just making moves. Last year, it was the Indians signing Christian Yelich and also Kyle Schwarber, and then the White Sox made a bunch of moves as well. And now we have to start evaluating our roster, because that makes two AL teams who we're chasing in the Yankees and also the Indians and also now the Twins great. I mean, they are just great. They have these great rosters signing these big money guys. So we now have to go after some guys. Corey Dickerson does end up signing with us, so he will be probably in that DH spot. No more Jesus Aguilar, I don't think, because now we have Dickerson there. He will also play a little bit of outfield. But then the Phillies signed Jose Ramirez, so at least the Indians do lose him. I mean, the Red Sox do lose him. And now Sonny Gray signs with the Rangers, so our division gets a little stronger. I don't think this was a huge move because the Rangers weren't really good, but maybe it puts them over the top. As the Indians signed Will Smith as well. I mean, these AL teams are loading up, and I think it's because everybody's just getting better, signing these good guys, and everybody's progressing. And remember, we missed the playoffs having 94 wins. That's incredible. So I look to sign some younger guys at free agency, some guys that have potential but really aren't there yet. And I sign a blankenship of first baseman, and he is pretty good with his power. And I need another power guy in our organization. I want to see our minor league team make the playoffs. But then it gets worse. The White Sox sign Jose Berríos. This is the last straw for me. I need to make a move. I don't know what it is, but just looking at these rosters, Yordan Alvarez is the top guy probably in the AL. Look at his attributes. I mean, this guy absolutely is going to rake for probably the next 10 years with the White Sox. I mean, look at this. His power versus right is 99, discipline's 99, clutch is 84. I mean, this is just incredible. The White Sox have a roster built to win multiple World Series now with signing Jose Berríos. They now have an ace. They also have Jose Altuve, who's coming off a year hitting 313. They also have Manoah and also Madison Bumgarner. I mean, look at this rotation. They have Berríos, Bumgarner, and now Rodon. I mean, everybody for that team is going to be maybe an all-star next year. It's incredible. But then I look at the Cleveland Indians, for example. They have four guys in the 90s overall. Will Smith, Schwarber, Bieber, and also Yelich. And then they're not too shabby behind him. Eduardo Escobar also signed with them in the offseason as well. Then the Red Sox. They have Sale. They have Devers. They have Bogarts. Now Trey Turner, Colton Wong, Odorizzi. I mean, they have a squad built to win. How about the Yankees? Gerrit Cole, Byron Buxton, Giancarlo Stanton. They do re-sign Chapman. He was a free agent. And now Joey Gallo. I mean, if we just need to compete with these guys, we have to go out and make a move. And let's just lastly take a look at the Angels. They still have Shohei Ohtani. I'm not sure how good he's doing, but I haven't really seen him too much. And as a pitcher, he's doing pretty terrible, to be honest. He should not be in the rotation. I'm not mad that he is, though, because he's not that good of a pitcher. But looking at them, they have Rendon, Mike Trout, Griffin Canning. And now we start to look at our roster, and we have to get stronger. We have to make a move. David Bote did not have a great year. He hit 232. We acquired him in season one, and he had that five-year, $15 million deal, which is very cheap for him. But I just need to upgrade somewhere. We need to do something. We need to make a move. I don't know what it's going to be. Next is Tyler Glasnow. We need to evaluate him a little bit. His strikeouts per nine is high at 89, one of the highest in the game, actually. And the production just isn't there. In that postseason last year, he had a pretty good run. But besides that, 1.53 whip in pretty much a full season with us. And then a 1.68 whip last year, going 8-15 with the number one offense. That's just unacceptable. But then I look at Forrest Whitley, and man, do I want to get rid of Forrest Whitley? I've had years to develop him. But to go after a guy like Yoan Moncada, I think I might have to do it. I need a superstar, and I think bringing in Moncada could definitely help this organization as a whole as other teams start to get stronger. He hit 304 last year. He's still 27 years old. One of the best fielding third basemen in the game. I also can use him at other infield positions if I really need it, if I have a third baseman that is ready to play there, because I do have Geraldo Herrera also in our organization. He's going to be ready to play within 1 to 2 years, so having Moncada there on the corner of the infield will definitely help. So I have to offer all three of those guys in order to get Moncada. And I also come back with a couple of other guys. David O'Neill is a lefty, but he's just a throw-in guy. But Trevor Richards is a guy that actually might be in the rotation this year, at least in the bullpen. We'll have to see. Or he might just be a minor league guy. So I decide to execute that trade and trade for Moncada. So a preview of what our lineup will look like. This is what it might look like. It's going to be Moncada in the two hole behind Justin Thompson. Carlos Santana actually does sign that tender offer, so he will be back. Remember, he won the batting title in the AL, so I do need him back. And he will now play in the field at first base. Corey Lee and Jake Cave probably are going to switch off at the four hole. Jake Cave got that extension. I like him at the four, but I think that adding Corey Lee, a guy ahead of him with speed, and then bringing in Jake Cave in that five hole, I think that that makes more sense because Santana isn't really a speed guy. But if I can get Corey Lee on base and then bring up Jake Cave coming up, I can maybe get a gapper and then, you know, produce more runs with Corey Lee because he's got speed. Now, Nate Barron will probably start at second now over Yonny Hernandez. I like Yonny, but I think that Nate Barron has more upside hitting the ball. Brantley moves down the lineup. He actually disappointed me a little bit, so I'm going to move him down to probably the 7 or 8 hole. I don't know where yet. And then Jeremy Pena will hit last in the lineup. You got to have a good hitter last. I think that Pena and Thompson will switch off hitting leadoff and last. I don't know which one's going to bat where right now. But looking at our rotation, I think this is what it's going to look like now. Joe Musgrove, Pablo Lopez, Alex Wood is going to be in that 3 spot now. So we have a good 3 spot rotation guy. I think that's where we struggled last year with Glasnow. He went 8-15. Teddy Politis had a good rookie year, but now it's time for Jimmy Pelko. He's had 2 years in the minors. He is 78 overall, and with morale, I'm not sure why it's down. I think it's because of his contract, but that is what it's going to look like going into the season. So we look a little bit different. We also have the white jerseys here, as you can see Musgrove wearing them for the first time. And here we head into spring training. That is going to do it here in the offseason. I mean, just a ton of moves. Jesus Aguilar is still in free agency, so if we really need to sign him, we can do so throughout the season. I'm not sure if we do really need him now, but I like the offseason we just had. And as we head into season 4, it's going to be interesting with Musgrove, with now Moncada, our new star. I like what we did to keep up with these other teams in the AL. So let me know what you guys think of the moves, and let me know what you guys think of the offseason. Hit subscribe, hit that like button, stay tuned. Let's get it. Let's go. Yeah, hey, filling out these job applications. Life got hard after high school graduation. I went to college and your boy got financial aid. They gave me money, then I went and bought a pair of J's. And I bought a pair of shades. And I bought a new computer. Half $400 left, spent the rest on...